The new Jaguar XK8 echoes all the grace and power of the great Jaguar sports cars of the past. Yet it's one of the most technically advanced vehicles ever produced. We wish you many miles of enjoyable and exhilarating motoring.
When you think about Corvette, the first thing that probably comes to mind is power. It gives you a smooth, comfortable, quiet ride, responsive, controlled handling, and precise steering control, whether you're in a performance driving situation or just running around town.
Hey everybody, we've got a great video for you today because what we have here are two early 2000s V8 powered sports cars that would have competed for the same money if you were an older person with golf clubs in the back. But here's what I'm talking about. This is a 2002 Jaguar XK8. The base price on this car, right around 74 grand back in the early 2000s. And at the same time they were building this Jag, they were building this, the C5 Corvette. The base price on this car, right around $42,000 or so. So we're rewinding the clock to find out which car you should have bought.
Yeah, because today we are going to do a drag race, a rolling drag race, and a braking test to see which of these 30 years later is the better car today.
It's actually 20 years, Dad, not 30 years.
Yeah, true that. I guess the cars aren't the only thing that's getting a little bit long in the tooth.
Oh, right, Dad. It's a really fun video today, right? Because these are two cars that were around at the same time, slightly geared at different audiences, but ultimately bought by the same old dude with golf clubs. So I'm in this Jaguar XK8 convertible, powered by a 4-liter AJ V8 engine, 290 horsepower, rear-wheel drive, of course. How about you?
Dude, I've got the classic Chevy 350, the LS1, 5.7 liters of American tire-burning horsepower. And speaking of horsepower, just under 350.
But you only have a 4-speed automatic, and I've got 5 English Craftsman gears. Actually, I'm not sure this transmission's English, but we both are in stock vehicles except for the exhaust. Both of these have modified exhaust. Let me see what this Jaguar sounds like.
I gotta tell you, that's a beautiful note that comes out of this 4-liter. That's incredible.
Yeah, our magic muffler man did that, Dan. Okay, I've got an
aftermarket exhaust, so let me see what mine sounds like.
Yeah, you may have won that one. As raspy as this Jaguar is, that the Corvette sounds incredible.
Hey, by the way, I'm getting tired of that old man golf club analogy. These things have now gotten old enough where they're way cool. This is a young man's car, dude.
That Corvette maybe, but I'm not sure a lot of young guys are lusting after a 20-year-old Jaguar XK8, as cool as it may be.
Yeah, there's a lot of wood in there. Maybe too much.
More wood than at an old man strip club. That's right, Dad. All right, let's do this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go 3, 2, 1, go. And when I say go, we blast down the quarter mile and see who wins.
I am in gear. I'm in performance mode with my ride control, and I'm ready to smoke your
old man woody car.
Yeah, maybe not as bad as you might think. The car's got some tricks up its sleeve. Okay, here we go. In 3, 2, 1, go.
You're launching a Jaguar. I'm actually slightly ahead of him.
Oh, it's neck and neck, but here comes the Corvette.
First gear is pretty strong in the Jag, but then that LS1 hits the higher RPMs, and he just took off.
Oh yeah, that is a glorious sound, even if it's a slow shift.
That's 75 miles an hour indicated in the Jaguar.
Come up to 80, almost 90, and left time in dust, finally achieved it. Oh my, 15.28. 15.28.
My satellite thing completely lost satellites as soon as I accelerated.
You want to do a redo?
Yeah, my GPS performance timer just took a dump on me. But I guess I can lose twice. Why not? Let's see. Let's do it again.
You want a head start?
Yeah, give me like a second head start. You know what's interesting is that I took you off the line.
But then, you know, you definitely caught up. But maybe with just a slight head start. Granted, the NHRA doesn't grant head starts, but, you know, well, let's see if I can maybe come back.
You know, with spring here, a young man's mind, as well as an old man's mind, turns to, and I know what you're thinking, but really, a convertible. And if you're interested in this particular convertible, we're actually selling it because it's time to move it on to a new home. So if you're interested in this car, it's got 79,000 miles and everything works. We sorted it out. Send us an email to info@tflcar and we'll send you all the particulars. I'm feeling like I can take this race as well.
All right, in 3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, good head start in the Jag.
Come on, Corvette. Oh, I see him. I'm coming up on him.
Listen to that V8. That is incredible. Oh, he's way back there.
I'm gaining.
He's gonna have to do some major catching up.
Oh, so close! And, oh, I think he just caught me at the line.
Well, you know, you were being a little too cheeky there, Dad. So I did the quarter mile at 16.9 at 87 miles an hour. So you were a full second and a half in front of me. Yeah, I mean, I think two things are happening. We're at a mile above sea level. Both of these cars are low mileage, and both of them are running really well, but that mile above sea level really hurts these NAV8s.
Yeah, so I went 15.26 at 98.7 miles an hour.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it is a Corvette.
Well, let's do this, Dad. Maybe my 5-speed automatic will help me in the roll race, and yeah, we'll hear some more glorious V8 engine notes.
Yeah, this one might be a closer one than people think because this 4-speed really does shift slowly.
And my 5-speed is pretty good, so we'll just leave them in drive and see who's responds quicker.
It's funny, the British are always very proud of the technology.
And you gotta admit that at least in this kind of America versus Britain comparison, they do have a better, or at least a transmission with more gears.
What's funny about these XK8s is everyone gives them a lot of hell because they think it's a Jaguar and it's going to be super unreliable, but these cars were actually developed under the Ford era and they have a pretty good reputation, especially the post-2000 model years. So yeah, it's actually been a really good ownership experience in this car.
Yeah, that's a facelifted one, and you know, let's be honest here. Jaguar has not have a great reputation for reliability, but the ones under Ford are about as good as they get.
Do that. All right, let's go up to 30.
Nose to nose here, Dad. There's 20, 25, and 30. Okay, full throttle in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh. Jaguar shutting down pretty well. Listen to that LS1. He is in the way. Well, Dad, the weight advantage certainly comes into play. Even though you are slightly heavier than me, the car is quite a bit lighter. So that Corvette is about 3,300 pounds. This Jaguar, about 3,800 pounds. So that's where we're seeing a big difference.
Hey, well, you know, wood is heavy, dude.
Yeah, it is a heavy material to make an entire interior out of. That's right. But let's go ahead and do the brake test. So we're gonna accelerate up to 60 miles an hour, excuse me, and then when we get to the cones, we're gonna slam on the brakes and see which one stops better.
All right, let's do this.
That raspy 4-liter does sound good. This car was so quiet with the stock exhaust. We removed a couple resonators, and it really comes into its own. All right, I just got to 6 feet here. I wanna come nose to nose with me. Down for a second and speed back up. Okay, a little quicker. There you go, there's 60. Nice, okay, hold it there and then stop at the cones. 60 miles an hour, indicated, and ooh, ABS working. Ah, the Jaguar. Gosh, that Corvette just keeps beating me. There you go, it had 132 feet.
But I just noticed something, Tommy.
Oh, what?
I didn't know this, but we've got Pilot, Michelin Pilot Sports on the back.
Yep.
Tell them what's on the front.
Oh, yeah. Fusion WHPs.
Yeah, so they are a little mismatched.
Woo! 111.
That's pretty good.
It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, that is pretty awesome. I think, you know, given the surface and given the fact that these cars are now 23 years old,
yeah,
that's pretty good. So, I have an idea.
Okay.
You know, usually the winner takes on a different car.
Yeah.
In this case, because we've already done the race with this competitor, I want to have the loser take on a different car. So, could I bring another car to race against you?
Yeah, maybe a modern, affordable car that appeals to the masses.
In fact, the cheapest electric car you can buy.
Okay, Dad, so I see you brought the Chevrolet Bolt EV, the new one. What's the horsepower on that car?
Well, Tommy, it's 200, so less than yours, but, you know, immediate torque and front-wheel drive.
You say front-wheel drive like it's a great thing for performance. You do have a sport mode, though. I have my transmission. There's like a little S mode here on the transmission, too. And yeah, it's going to be interesting. You're still like 200 pounds lighter in that car than the Jag, but I have 90 more horsepower now. But then we're at elevation, which hurts my car. I don't know. It should be a fun race.
Yeah, I mean, the elevation thing I think is huge, right? Because really, electric cars aren't affected by elevation. In fact, there's less air density, which means that this car should be slipperier. If it in fact is, it might have actually a lower coefficient of drag.
Okay, well, should we give this a go?
Hold on, I gotta turn on my sport button.
Sport mode engaged.
Gonna send us to a red battle, but I think the Jaguar definitely sounds better.
True that. All right, let's do this.
All right, quarter mile coming up in 3, 2, 1, go.
Launch in the Jag. It is neck and neck.
It's close, but there goes the Bolt. He had the shift.
There goes that EV torque, though. Right around 35 miles an hour. He is pulling ahead. That little Bolt is pretty quick.
I'm really pulling away from the Jaguar. Yeah, I'm going to hit my top speed pretty soon. And there we go. Oh my, this is almost as fast as the Corvette, Tommy.
How'd you do?
15.83.
Okay, I ran a 17.1 at 87. Yeah, that little lunchbox goes pretty well.
90 miles an hour, dude.
Yeah, mine is 87.
But if this race was, I don't know, a mile longer, I have a higher top speed, so I would have passed you.
It just goes to show you, you know, 21 years of technological advancement, and as much as people like hate or love to hate on electric cars, they are quick in a straight line.
Well, clearly from a performance standpoint, the Corvette was the winner here. It's just a much more high performance oriented car, but as a comfy cruiser with a much better interior and a power convertible top, it's hard to beat these Jaguars, especially considering how much more affordable they are compared to that Chevrolet Corvette. And as a follow-up, Dad, I think it'd be really cool if one of you guys out there could bring in an XK8R to see how that would stack up.
Yeah, I gotta say, as much as I love the Corvette, it does have a lot more plastic, Tommy.
It does, yeah, and it certainly isn't as nice on the inside.
And it's gonna be sad to see the Jaguar go. We've had a lot of fun with it. And by the way, if you guys are interested in it, feel free to send us an email at info@tflcar. And yes, you can peel those stickers off and make it black again.
Yeah, for sure. Well, guys, thank you so much for joining us on this video. We've had a ton of fun making it. This has been Tommy.
And Roman saying thanks for watching. And remember, go to alltfl.com for all of our news, views, and of course, drag race reviews. See you guys next time. Ciao.